Hey guys, welcome back to the Limited Queue. I haven't really been posting a lot of drafts for Oath of the Gatewatch. There are some sets that I really, really love and I draft them a lot. Cons was one of those, Fate Reforged is one of those. I didn't draft a lot in Dragons and I didn't post a lot of drafts because of that. When I'm not really appreciating the draft scene for the current set, I usually move into Standard. So I've been playing a lot of Standard for the current format. I'm not that big of a fan of the Oath of the Gatewatch draft format. I personally feel as though the set is drafted incorrectly. I feel like it should be Battle first, and then the two Oath packs. I feel like a lot of the archetypes are cut out the way that the current draft format is set up. And I've pretty much, other than just playing with my friends and playing in FNM once in a while, I've decided to opt out of drafting of this set for the most part. I've been playing an awful lot of Standard, and today I'm going to be playing with the deck that literally I've been trashing people with. This deck has won me two different IQs, this current Standard season. I'm going to be probably taking some version of this to the SCG Invitational in Columbus and an RPTQ. So if you're going to be at the New York RPTQ in the end of May, make sure you say hi to me. In addition, I gave the build to my good friend Daniel, and he ended up winning an IQ with it as well. I think he also won a GPT with it that he's going to be taking a GP New York. And when I was at GPDC, I took this deck just to play in the side events. I played in six Standard events from Friday through Sunday at GPDC. And throughout all six events, I lost one match. So that's six whole tournaments. I lost one match with this deck. There are some minor changes between Daniel's build and my build. He sides in Kozilek, and he convinced me to put Void Winnower on the sideboard. So we're going to be running this list shown here on Star City Games. The only change I made to the list is I took out a Crumble to Dust and I put in a Void Winnower on the sideboard. So we're going to have a lot of fun, and, well, theoretically have some fun. We're going to kick some people's asses with this deck, and I'm going to show you how it's done, and I will post the full deck list in the description down below. Thank you for watching, and let's play some Standard. Hey, welcome back. Today we're going to be showcasing the red-green ramp deck that I've been playing an awful lot of. Definitely getting in a lot of reps with this deck. I've been doing really well with it, actually. 1, 2, 3, keep. And bottom. This specific deck has taken me to many first place finishes. Looks like we're playing against blue Eldrazi or red blue Eldrazi. Okay, I thought that was going to be a horribly awry for a second. I was going to be impressed. Not looking especially good for us here. That does help us out a bunch, though. Thank you. three of them? Okay. Oh, he has no cards in his hand, so we get to go Ugin for the win. I was thinking about playing around Stubborn Denial there for a second. Let's bring in the Jaddi Offshoots to offset his aggro. Let's bring in this is Renewal, the Sowers, 1-2. Let's take out Ugin's 2-3, which leaves us with an Ulamog. Let's put in a Cozy Return. And let's take out the Oaths. 1-2-3-4. And last but not least, let's take out one Nissa. Seems good. No motion, but he mulliganed to 5, and we have an early drop, so I'm happy with where we are.
Hey!
What's up, beautiful?
Are you recording?
Yep.
What's
up?
I'm just gonna invite my friend to go hide at that hole.
Okay, sure.
So do you want to invite Peter?
If you want.
If she's going.
We're just going to take 4 here, this way we can close the next turn and then swing in next turn. Sure, I'll invite Peter.
No, let me invite that one first. If she's not going, why would you?
Alright, next game. What's going on? We got another standard victim. Let's do it. Let's also sign up for this single elimination here. Love playing first with this deck. Wunderbar. A little sketchy, but we'll keep it. I mean, obviously it'd be better if one of these world breakers was a Nissa's Pilgrimage, but whatever. Prairie Stream. It's either Bant Company or Rally. The reason we get our non-basics there is because the search spells, Nissa's Pilgrimage and Veggies, both search for all the basics. And also, now that we have those on board, we no longer need to worry about things coming into play tapped. I've seen this. Oh, this is a... The white weenie deck that's going around, maybe? People, for some reason, think that this is good. I've never lost to it. The two-for-ones are very real and available in this deck. Like this one right here. See ya. And yeah, our opponent Matt is mana scared, so it's a little bit like gloating about kicking a toddler. But at the same time, he did choose to keep the hand. But yeah, this is a white weenie deck. It runs Archangel of Tithes. I like the concept. I think that it needs to be running Eldrazi as well in order to be viable. I don't know why people aren't running Thought Not Seer and Reality Smasher with it. I mean, like, maybe I haven't been too up on the meta. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I guess maybe Saffron Olive must have done some type of expo on, like, his Savannah Lions deck for standard. And, you know, I could see that having an impact on what people decide to play. But what is this? Green White Weenie? Consul's Lieutenant was discarded. White Weenie Coco? That doesn't matter. This was basically just free money. 1, 2. Let's keep the return in the graveyard. There's no need to do that just yet. And our opponent should be scooping within seconds. Yes. Fuck it. Let's get it off the field so I can get in for 5 quicker. We're losing a colorless. There is an argument that we're just showing our opponent our deck at this point, and I'm fine with that, because it's not like you don't know that we're not running huge things that'll smack you in the face. Alright. So he's running Weenie. Let's bring in Cozy Return, Jaddi Offshoots for sure, and the Oblivion Sowers to speed us up. This is Renewal, maybe. Nissa herself can go out because she's more suited for a long game. Let's take out the Oaths, and we gotta drop 2. Let's drop Ulamog, and let's drop a Worldbreaker? Yeah. Alright, game 2. Let's keep. Our opponent mulled again. Not looking great for him. How are we doing on our single man? Okay. Five people in the single elimination queue. He starts off with the Prairie Stream again. I like having the double Sylvan Advocate in hand. I don't think he actually... Did he... Yeah, he didn't see the Sylvan Advocate last game. That's going to sting a little. It does back us up a bit. Especially when we draw a third one. So this looks like Uber Budget Bant Coco. Best possible draw here would be Explosive Veggies. Get a forest and a mountain. Command aggroed out. Deck is kind of tripping on itself here. I mean, I guess next turn, even if we don't have enough. That kind of sucks. 1, 2, 3, 4. And nothing to do, huh? Okay. Oh, well, I mean, I guess we could do that. Losing to Reflector Mage solo beatdown. That's a big Reflector Mage. Thank you. Jeez. Don't get counterspelled. Sweet. Probably should have held on to the cozy return, huh? We lose. That was a pathetic showing. That was really, really, really pathetic. All right. Come on, Dex, just make me feel good. Give me a land. Now. You're a dick. Pathetic. All right, Napes UK. I guess you got us. Wow. Let's play against Frank Lepore. You know, the modern savant that basically recreated an archetype. Frank Lepore is a pro. He's been playing for about 20 years. We are on the play against him. I'm good with it. Abzan aggro for sure. He's on something more original. Looks like black, green, ramp, or elves. Elves would be cool. So far, this is all Shadows legal. Interesting. Curious if that's what he's going for. I did have a choice between Ugin and Chandra there, but I decided to keep the Ugin around. Let's blast him. let's get rid of your Hissing Quagmire. I've got a feeling we got Coco incoming. Yep. If he had had one less land, I would have blasted him with Ugin after, not before. It's pretty obvious that he was going to Coco there. We draw a shrine, then we can cast Ulamog next turn. If we don't, then we can cast either Ugin or Worldbreaker. Yikes, that's damage. All coming at me, huh? Well, I guess he knows it. It's not... Oh, yeah, I didn't think so. Because it's not lethal. Yeah, it's all going at Ugin. So let's kill off Nissa. Now, what's interesting, it's actually more economical for us to play Chandra and minus two here, which would wipe his board, rather than play the Ugin and minus five. Yeah. Let's bring in Cozy. Let's bring in the Jaddi Offshoots. Let's bring in the Sowers. Because, you know, that worked so well for us last time. Oh, he just... Frank Lepore just scooped to us? Okay. Thanks, Frank. Okay, my match has started. I don't know which match this is, though. Okay, oh, both of our matches have started. So we are in, this is the single elimination. And here, all right, so we're double queued. Let's play. Oath seems good. Keep this. Go over here. One, two, three. Seems good. Keep this. Go back to Scuttlebutt. Play this. We need to find a land, so let's make sure we do that. Let's take a forest. Chandra, forest, go away. F6. Go over here. It's his main phase, probably the mirror. Okay. We're actually poorly situated against the mirror that runs. Ramp creatures. And the reason I chose a Cinder Glade over Forest into Oath of Nissa there is because I want to make sure that we get there first. Oath of Nissa we could always use later. Oh, Hardened Scales, hello. Let's go you, Sylvan Advocate. Over here, it's our main phase, let's go here. No Nissa yet, huh? Sorry. Like there's shenanigans going on over here. Should probably get down that Oath of Nissa next turn, just so in case he casts Hydra, he doesn't get extra counters. Flying, okay. I don't know why that's taking so long, so let's go over to Scuttlebutt. We get to play this, we get to go Nissa. Search for a forest. Yep. F6. Go back to here. Let's pick up... Pick up a Worldbreaker. No idea what's going on with Frank Lepore. What did he take? He took a Veggies. Okay. Not bad considering we have two of them. One, two, three, four. Mountain, mountain. Go. What are we doing over here? Let's get in. See us walking away from this one, guys. Foothills. Mountain. Veggies. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So next turn we can go Ugin, and I think that's our only chance. Six. And we're going to be at 2. So assuming he doesn't have Dromoka's Command. Minus 3. Guardian of Tazim. Okay. Legitimately weirded out by that one. We play the Wooded Foothills there on purpose. This way, you know, it's just a good habit to get into, because if he had something, we could snap Wooded Hill. If he had something to kill our Nissa in response to the trigger, we could snap Wooded Foothills back. In response to his spell. So let's exile the mirror pool here. It's a scary card. And we theoretically even this one up. Now over here, what's going on? Oh, he just scooped to us. Okay, sounds good. So against Hardened Scales, we're in trouble, to be honest with you. This is one of our worst matchups. So we bring in an Ugin. Let's bring in Sower, just because it has a big ass. Renewals. And offshoots. The weird thing about this matchup is that the Kozilek's return actually does not do a whole lot for us unless we're killing Hangerback tokens. Let's take out the Oaths. Let's take out Ulamog because it's too slow. Let's take out Chandra's. Chandra's? No. Let's take out Nissa's. One, two, and finally let's take out Worldbreaker. Over here, what's going on over here? Okay, he played a land, tapped down a Worldbreaker. Okay. He's going to bounce our token. Okay, this is cool. Wow. Okay, I like this. This is interesting. I mean, I guess we get to go Oath of Nissa into Nissa if we don't pull another Worldbreaker. But he's got to send something at Nissa here, right? Yeah, so we're only taking 4. Oath of Nissa first before we play Sanctum. Well, that sucks. Thank you. Seriously? Wow. I don't know what we need to draw here, but it needs to be good. That's not it. Alright, let's make our opponent kill us. Ooh, game three, I'd snapped in the seed, but, you know. Wow. I'm actually... Okay, so it's like mono blue lockdown. Cute. How do we sideboard for this? Let's take out the Ugins. Put in an Ulamog. Put in Gaea's Revenges. And a Crumble. Let's take out the Oaths. Submit. Let's go back over here. You know, Mulligan? No, this is basically a perfect hand for us. Opponent's definitely in trouble here. And let's apologize for the delay. But he's taking forever anyway, so we go back over here. Yes, let's play first. Gamble, gamble. Whoa. Dinner is served. Thank you, baby. What's that look on your face? Come here, kiss.
An off-camera kiss. I'm impressed. Thank you, dear.
Dinner of home-cooked lo mein has been served. Thank you, babe. Sorry for eating on camera. This is a... Hey, Soph? Do I keep this hand? I need to draw a forest in the first three turns or I'm fucked.
No. Not at all.
Thank you, Angel.
There's a lot of gold in it. That smells so bad.
I can taste it. It tastes great. All right. Let's send it back. Keep it. What happened over here? Did you make any extra beyond this, or is this it?
That's it. Oh. That's all the noodles we have.
We should have bought more.
We didn't go to the supermarket for like 2 weeks. That host boyfriend works in KPMG.
Dato has a boyfriend?
Yeah.
That's new, right?
Not new. She didn't tell me for 1 year.
Good friend you have.
She only told one or two people. Her parents didn't even know that.
Alright. So we do have a good draw, but we are playing against Hardened Scales, which is probably one of our worst matchups. next turn we get to go Worldbreaker and exile Hangerback, which he's wasted all these turns pumping up. That's going to be good for us. He just Valorous Stanced his own dude. Oh, this is gonna hurt. Now, if he goes Hardened Scales minus Nissa, do we lose? One, two. Yeah, I think we do. So we've won the first round of the single elimination, which means we at least get our money back. That's good. We did the Atarka instead of making a token because we know that he has a lot of tap effects. Or, sorry, bounce effects. So if he's going to bounce our stuff, I want him to regret it. And also, against blue, we're going to start using Nissa for a lot of card advantage whenever we can. Get rid of the cataract. Let's kill his Icefall Regent. Keep the other one in the yard. Is this where we can kill his next thing? No. Yes, let's sack this. Alright, he's just going to scoop to that. I don't blame him. Alright, So that's how that works. Kozilek's return seems good, huh? Let's take out a crumble, put in Kozilek's return. Submit. I always keep hands like this. Sketchy as hell. Maybe I shouldn't be doing it, but that's what I do. They always end up biting me in the ass, though. Alright, sweet. Probably Sower is what he takes here. Because he can't stop me from getting a shit ton of lands. Some gas would be nice. That's it. He's got it. Oh. So I guess we're losing a bruise today. That just happened to be our MO. I'm going to pause this while I finish up my food. Alrighty. Round two of our single elimination match has begun. Yes, let's play first. No ramp. I hate hands like this. I think we have to keep it. Might have just thrown the game away for ourselves, but that's okay. I guess. Like our opponent also has a slow start. Well, that's just about perfect for us. Can't be stubborn denied. Does he have Disdainful Stroke? Main deck? Oh, okay. Ew. I guess the good news is that we're killing stuff no matter what, right? I don't know what he takes here. This is a tough call for him. I think next turn we're going to go Chandra minus four. Takes Ugin, huh? Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. All right, yeah. So we can go Chandra, minus four, and then Sylvan Advocate. Make a dangerous play here. We're gonna go veggies. And then if he doesn't Thought Not Seer Ulamog out of our hand, we get to do that next turn. Hello. Can't say I didn't call it. I forgot we had Kozilek's return in the graveyard. I would have swung first. Let's get rid of the Ghostfire Blade. Sure, let's just kill everything. Sure, let's sack that. Get ourselves a Worldbreaker. Okay. Sack that. Get ourselves a Worldbreaker. Alright. He's going to scoop. Let's put in Kozilek's return. Sower. Take out the Ugins. The question is, do we want to swap out Oath of Nissa for Jaddi Offshoots? Well, the answer is, let's do half and half. Let's put in two Crumbles, because I like taking him off of his colorless. Let's take out Ulamog. And then one, two, three Jaddi Offshoots. And a Nissa's Renewal. And a Jaddi Offshoot. We'll take out two Nissa's for that. Seems good. All right. Unfortunately, can't keep this specific one lander. Let's mull it. One, two... Sure, keep it. Bottom, because we need lands. Surprised that didn't get countered. Getting the Kozilek's return done there does a lot of things for us. Number one, gives us a 4-5 next turn because we're going to be playing a land. And it also puts Kozilek's return in the yard for us for the future. For shitty situations like this. And this is great because now we get to take him off 5. Set up lands for Oblivion Sower next turn, and get Sylvan Advocate on the board. 2 Encase in Ices and a Skyspawner in hand. Now there's going to be a lot of mana on our side of the board next turn. Ooh, that actually sucks for us. That sucks a lot. That's really bad. He definitely top decked the right card for himself there. Not what we needed. Well, that top deck thought not sayer for the win, huh? Okay. I'll try my hardest not to be salty about that. Huh. Let's keep it. Play. Keep this. Let's do this. Thank you.
stop shaking.
I'm only at 39 instead of the 41 I was just at. Okay. All right, let's go to the finals. Bitches. Actually, you know what? While we're doing that, let's play more standard. Against Albatar.
Elria.
Albatar.
Elria.
You're an Ur-ur-ur. Let's keep this bad boy of a hand. Yeah, I'm badass and I use terms like that. My girlfriend doesn't laugh at me when I do, right, babe?
What?
Yeah, exactly.
What?
Nothing. Love you.
Anyway.
Rar, rar, rar. You're an error. Rar. She is wildly addicted to,
Oh, yeah, you're not.
Clash of Royals.
Yeah, you're not.
I know I'm not. She's been thinking about starting her own Clash of Royals YouTube channel.
It's impossible.
Why is it impossible? You can totally do it.
I didn't say that I'm on YouTube.
More hardened scales. We lost this the last hardened scales match we played. Huh? Alright. Well, this is actually one of my favorite setups in the game. We get to go third turn Nissa's Pilgrimage into fourth turn Pilgrimage plus Hedron Archive. I guess that's reverse, but sure, you know what I'm talking about. Yikes. Turn four, we have basically all of the mana. We're also taking all of the damage. Thank you.
Yep. Let's do it. We're going to do two planeswalkers. We're going to do Nissa into Chandra. And hopefully we're not staring down Disdainful Stroke, right? Oh, that was cool. Oh, Hardened Scales, you're so cute. Thank you.
back to the ranch. Do not come back. Please don't come back.
I like Oblivion Sower in this matchup because his big butt keeps stuff out of our...
Just like my giant!
And your big butt in general.
Oh my god, he dropped the giant.
Yeah, Ugin's coming down next turn.
I have baby giant. Just like Ugin. Revenge.
I did that in reverse order. That was dumb of me. I should have minus Ugin and then swung with Sower. Oh well. That's not how that works, buddy. This game ends. We got one more game, and then we're back over to our finals. Let's run this back. Yes, let's play first. Oh. Send it back. Is this a mirror? I think it is. I'm going to take the fourth land here just because I want to be guaranteed to get my Hedron Archive out. Thank you. love this turn four play. I know I mentioned it before and we lost that game. It really is just my favorite. Five, six, seven, eight, nine next turn. Sower? Conduit. This is gonna hurt. Four, eight, nine, huh? Yikes. I don't think we win this one, guys. Sorry. But we are winning the important match, which is the finals of our single elimination. Huzzah! Alright. So in the mirror, we bring in the Crumbles, and since he's got the mana critters, we bring in Kozilek's Return. Bring in Renewal, bring in Sowers, and we put in Void Winnower. We take out one Chandra, Dragon Lords. And the Advocates. And because we're bored, we also start another standard match. Double queuing is kind of addicting. You know what else is kind of addicting? Cadbury Easter eggs are on sale because it's right after Easter, they're always like 50 to 70% off. So stock up now because these things are amazing. They should sell them year round. They really should. Hey, Soph. If I get super fat off of Cadbury Easter eggs, will you dump me?
If I lose right now, I'm going to dump you for sure.
Yeah, I don't mind right now because I already got my 10
scrum.
Oh yeah, nice job.
Motherfucker. Yeah. Oh. Look at my arrows. Fuckers. Look at those baby dragons.
We're probably going to lose. If he has a turn 2 mana creature, I'm pretty sure we just lose this. Our deck is not situated well for the mirror. The Rattle Claws really do make it a turn faster.
Haha, I got two dragons.
Sweet. We have a chance.
Yes. What? Clash Japan. Go to hell. Ah.
These guys are boring me. Should we start up a third match? Do we disconnect?
Nice try.
Nope. Oh, somebody's doing something. Ulamog. Yep.
type in it. Why can't you type on Clash Royale? Right?
I'm playing another mirror over here against Exorcist. He says that his whole deck is post-rotation except for three Rattleclaws. Now, I'm pretty sure that he doesn't really realize that all that means is he's not running Ugins. BFD. Kind of want to like give him a golf clap here, because most of the deck is survives post-rotation except for the Rattleclaws. Both of these guys are going really slow. Okay, here we go. Keep. Well, that conveniently kills both our guys. Three, four, five, six, seven. Yep. Cool, so we get to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Nissa, and then Worldbreaker? Sweet. We could have saved Nissa there by banging out Blighted Woodland, but I don't think it was worth it.
isn't it?
Mulling to four on the draw here. The sick thing is that we might actually get there if he lets us go crumble into something crazy. Has Ulamog in hand. One, two, three, four, five. So we need to go Worldbreaker. Oh no. We need to go shunt. We need to do this and kill the morph. Otherwise, he's going to have enough land for Ulamog next turn. Now he only has 9. If he played a land. We might actually pull this other one off where we mulled to 4 on the draw. So now we're gonna hit all of his shrines into Oblivion Sower. We could cast just about everything, huh? He only has 2 shrines in the deck? Okay. He's got 2 glades, 4 sanctums. One, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So he's going to go conduit next turn, and then we're kind of screwed. He goes conduit, we go sower, he goes worldbreaker. Okay. I guess that is what it is. The hell happened over here? Oh, we killed the other one.
Now he's doing this other thing, huh? Okay. Eight. I think we have to kill this and then go for a shrine, right? 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, yeah, definitely. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Yeah, he's still one short. Okay, that's fine. Because then we get to Worldbreaker, his other shrine. Okay, so he cast Conduit Suit, and that put him on the top. So he just exiled his whatever? Sweet. What did he put on top? Revealing Worldbreaker. Like, he thinks that's good game somehow? Okay, if you say so, buddy. Okay. That was, nah. I don't think there was anything we could have done there. Why do people think Conduit is good? Okay, so he put Void Winnower on top, which we're just going to mill away right now. Yeah, that's a lot of damage. Okay, so we lose this one. But whatever, we mold to 5, I think, on that one, so let's just run that back. He exiled his own shrines. I want to make it so that if he attacks with Ulamog, we can just crack back for the win.
Oh my god, we definitely want to save audio points
That's when. Wait. 6, 7. Ah, we're one short. Okay. Six. I think that might have been the wrong move, the Pilgrimage instead of the Worldbreaker there, because now that leaves him open to go swing with Ulamog, then drop Ulamog, I think, for the win, and that leaves him that out. So if he has another Ulamog in his hand, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and he draws a land, then we're screwed.
He just scooped. Sweet. Good games, Geoscope. And that's how we win an 8-man single limb. Now let's try to wrap it up over here as well. That sanctum's getting crumbled. Ulamog. So he's definitely on a slow hand. And we should have this when we Worldbreak our flashback, Kozilek's return next turn. We're going to Worldbreak our shrine, and that's pretty much game over. He scoops. All right. So that is how I kick ass take names with ramp. Did lose a few weird matches to White Weenie and the blue Tron guy. Not sure if we lost to the blue red Eldrazi. But yeah. So that's what I've been doing lately instead of drafting. I just wanted to share the. I'll put the links to the build in the description down below. And thank you for watching. All right. Bye bye.